Grace, who have put up this program for us today. Let's give them a hand. And I also want to thank Nanay Inday, Nanay Remy, Nanay Cora, and Mommy for sharing with us their life story. But before I exhort to you the Word of God briefly, they told me about 10 to 15 minutes, I would like to invite them again to join me up here on the stage. So I'm calling our moms once again to be up here to join me. Have a seat, all night. So as I was saying earlier, I want to thank them for sharing their life story with us, sharing their experiences, whether good or bad. And I want to say that although their stories are unique and different from each other, they all had something in common. And what is that? You could see the hand of God upon their lives. Amen? You could see the hand of God upon their lives. We can see how God's faithfulness was evident. And we can also see God's blessings, His goodness, His mercy, and even during the times of hardship and trials, God was there for them. Even when they barely knew the message of salvation, even when they barely knew the God of the Bible, they knew to call upon the Lord. They revered God and had faith within them that God could hear them. And as we can see, God heard them. God was with them, caring for them, watching out for them, orchestrating every situation so that they can be here today, right now, declaring the marvelous works of God to us and to the next generation. In Psalm 71, verses 17 to 18, can you put up that verse, please, Carl? It says there that since my youth, O God, you have taught me, and to this day I declare your marvelous deeds. Even when I am old and gray, do not forsake me, O God, till I declare your power to the next generation, your might to all who are to come. And that is what they have done today. That is what they have declared in front of us today. God's faithfulness, God's power, and all the miracles that God has done in their lives. And because they have gone through these experiences and walked through many challenges in life, they have gained a lot of wisdom and a lot of understanding. The Bible says that the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. And so for all the younger women in this room, let us learn from the examples of the older women. Our theme today is mentoring ladies. And let's just briefly pray for a second. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord God, for today. We thank you for the mothers that we have, Lord. Lord, I pray that as we go into your word, Lord, that Lord, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. So before I go on to our text in Titus, I want to just first of all greet everybody Happy Mother's Day, and to all the ladies, Happy Ministry, Women's Ministry Day. And indeed, today is a very special day for all the mothers, because I hope that you have greeted your mom today. I hope that you have shown them your appreciation today, because mothers are a gift to us. Amen? Mothers are a gift to us, and just to think about it, they have labored so much to bring us forth into this world. If you think about it, they labored to bring us forth into this world. So I want to thank my mom for laboring and bringing me forth into this world, all 11 children. And I'm sure that you have recognized that also, that your mom has done so much for you. Right now, I just want to share to you briefly what my children has given to me this Mother's Day. And just briefly, I just can't let this go. I want to show to you what my son David gave to me for Mother's Day today. He gave me, I think it's Mongo Blend. And I like how the schools today encourage our children to create something for their parents or for their mother when it's Mother's Day, or father when it's Father's Day. And with that came it says, I love you. And there's a coloring thing in there, and it says, please color. So I have to color this.
Gave me homework.
That. And I want to share to you what Melody. Oh, sorry, no. With that, David also wrote me a letter. It's a very, very touching letter. He said, Dear Mom, you are the best mom I had in my life. Because you took care of me when I was a baby. a toddler, and when I was in her stomach, spelled S-T-A, stomach. And you cooked me food when Dad was at the store or at work, and thank you for saving me when I was choking on a vegetable. And when I had pneumonia. And he spelled pneumonia correctly because he said he asked the teacher, and the teacher looked it up in the dictionary. So that's really priceless to me. You know, it may not be an expensive jewelry or a free dinner to a fine restaurant, but these gifts to me are very priceless. Okay, for Melody. Melody wrote me a poem and also made this, I think it's a sun catcher. It says Mama in French because she's in first French immersion. And you hold it up on the window and you see all those different colors which they melted when they ironed it. And these are just wax paper for when you're baking. So, and with that came a poem, and she's in French immersion, so I'm going to read it to you in French and translate to you. Qui venait, c'est chien de fleur, c'est maman, maman bonheur. Qui chantait dans sa cuisine, c'est maman, maman pudding. Et le soir dans son lit chaud, c'est maman, maman dodo. Qui nous prenait sur son cœur, c'est maman bonheur. So basically, what she's saying here is, who dries our tears? It's our moms. Who sings in the kitchen? It's our moms. And at night, at bedtime, she's there. And also, who keeps us in her heart? It's mom. Aww. So, thank you, Melody. And this one is a card from James. And he says, Mom, you bring sunshine to my life. Son, James. So, I told you, it's priceless. And with that, he gave me this. This is really beautiful. This is a tile. Tile.
Look.
He made a cross. You see the cross? Yeah. Cross, and beside that there's a heart plant with a red heart. Okay, there you go. And on the left side it's a red rose. So he knows what I want. And when he told me a few weeks ago, he said, Mom, I'm making you something. I can't tell you what it is, but you're really gonna like it. Because you're into those things, he said. So thank you, James. So thank you to all my children for doing that. How are you? Okay, so to move on, let's go to Titus 2 verses, I included 3 to 5. Okay, Carl, slide please. Likewise, teach the older women to be reverent in the way they live, and not to be slanderers or addicted to much wine, but to teach what is good. Then they can train the younger women to love their husbands and children, to be self-controlled and pure, to be busy at home, to be kind, and to be subject to their husbands, so that no one will malign the word of God. So here the Apostle Paul is reminding Titus, a young servant of the Lord, to admonish and to teach the older women in the church to live a holy life, to speak words that only edify and encourage and lift, to utter only good things about other people, not to be slanderers, not to be super critics of everyone else, but to teach what is good. Also, in verse 4, it says here that then they can train and model godliness and teach the younger women. I know that Tess read that several times today. It says model godliness, you know. Happy Sleep Accent model. Okay, model. Okay, ever since I was a kid, I've always wanted to be a model. It's true. I used to stand in front of the mirror and pose and, you know, smile like this. And I remember my babysitter, Nana Elsa, she used to laugh and just let me model. And you know, today, I may not be Kate Moss or Linda Evangelista or Halle Berry,